happy Monday. It's the start of a new week. If you're new here, my name is Sonja and I'm a second year PhD student studying math. So the past few weeks I've been feeling kind of unmotivated and really slow, but this week I can feel it's already going to be better. At least I hope my feeling's right. So the past 2 weeks I've been a little unmotivated and also distracted by Wimbledon. And that finished yesterday. It was the championship game yesterday. My favorite player won and I was super happy, and he's on his way to getting lots of records, so I'm quite happy about that. Anyway, it's 9 a.m. and I need to get going for my day. Today I signed up for an outdoor fitness class with my friend. It's run by the university and that is at 5:15, so I have kind of like a cap on my day. Usually, like, if I think, oh, I have the whole day to study, I might do things a little bit slower, but maybe this will help me like focus more. And the first step is to figure out exactly the specific things I want to do today. So I'm going to go ahead and do that in Notion. So this is what I have put into my calendar. The first thing is writing this proof. It implies something. I just was kind of lazy to write it all out, but I know what it is. Basically, I'm trying to prove if you multiply any m plus 1 y's with whatever, why can't I think of this word? Index, I guess. Any non-negative integer index, you also get 0, so it doesn't matter if it's 0 or 1, or if it's like anything here, any I 0, I 1 to I m. Then I have this identity that I proved, and so this identity, if I pick a specific IS and JLs for this, this is like an M by M matrix or M plus 1 by M plus 1 matrix, it gives me a recurrence relation on these C's, and I want to say what the solution of that is. And that's all my academic stuff that I wrote in today's to-do. I did put some stuff here just for the week, things that I want to think about, but as I start taking off stuff here, I'll move this over to daily. And then I have my exercise class, which is at 5:15, so that's my limit of studying today. And then I'm going to practice Japanese, and I've been learning a bit about Norwegian, so I'm going to review my Norwegian vocab, and then watch a video in French, which I try to do daily just to keep up my French listening skills.
Par exemple, dans une boutique qui s'appelle À Rebours à Paris. En vrai, c'est un peu la série de cet été, puisque après ça, on préparera plutôt la rentrée, septembre, etc.
So I'm gonna start working on the first thing on my list, and I will try probably doing the Pomodoro method for doing that. So I'll do 50-10. That's what I like to do. And it's already 9:40. It took kind of a while planning this out. So that gives me like, I don't know, 2 or 3 sessions until I'm going to eat lunch. So it is time to work out. I'm gonna leave in 5 minutes. The only thing I'm worried about is that you need to show your student card so that you pay the gym fees, but I left mine at my parents' house, so I brought my like tuition statement improvement proof of enrollment, so hopefully they still let me join. All I'm bringing is the yoga mat, and we'll see how it goes. So I just came back from the workout and it was super hard. Like, I'm used to, I've just been working out for like 10 to 20 minutes at a time at home, and this was like a harder workout and longer, and now I feel like super dead. So I'm gonna take a shower and then probably eat dinner because I haven't eaten in like
6 hours or something. It's too long. And I also feel like drinking a cup of coffee, but I'm not sure if it's too late or not. It's 6:30, so I will see. So after showering, I still felt so tired from the workout that I just laid in bed and watched TikToks for like 30 minutes. But my boyfriend is cooking dinner right now, so I'm walking to his house to eat. Nice to not cook dinner, even though it took me a while to get the willpower to get out of bed. So I just downloaded some Norwegian learning podcasts, so I will listen to that on the walk because it's like a 30-minute walk. Tuesday. So yesterday I didn't do all of the things on my to-do list, but I got a lot done. I didn't really have time to do some of the language things because working out just knocked me out for the rest of the night. So today I have a meeting in about 45 minutes and I think that we're going to discuss what I wrote for my document. So I've been writing a document for my comprehensive exam and I sent this to my advisors last Friday, so they might have some comments about that. And after the meeting I want to talk about a little bit of what I did yesterday and some strategies and that theorem I was trying to prove before, which is finally done and looks much better than it was while I was in the middle of working on it. So I'll check in with you guys after the meeting. So I just had the meeting and yesterday on my list of things to do, the top one was to prove something, which I thought I could just do it yesterday and I didn't, and end up doing it by the end of the day, and I was a little bit disappointed that I wasn't able to do it. But in the meeting, my advisor said, well, both of them said they were trying to work on it and they realized that it's much more complicated and delicate than we at first thought, so that made me feel like less dumb than I was feeling yesterday. And it turns out to do that, like, I saw I had something to do with partitions and combinatorics of that, and I thought about Young diagrams yesterday for a little bit and then I dismissed that thought. But today my professor told me one way to try and prove this is through the use of Young diagrams, and I'm not an expert on them, like, I know what they are. If you don't know, I'll put a picture here. They're neat, they represent a partition. And so I have this book here on combinatorics, and until lunch I'll just read about them in here and maybe find some other resources, and then in the afternoon maybe try to go back and see if I can put anything I learned from this book into my process of solving this problem. But before I do that, I want to mention that theorem I was working on before, so that's all sorted out, and I'm just gonna pull up my document to show you. I'll insert a clip of what it was initially, which is horrible. And this is what it looks like now. So the theorem was this part here, so this module, it's a cyclic module with some relations, it's finite dimensional, and the proof is so small, it's just this. And it's because, well, this is after we found out if you have a module like that, it actually exists. Like in algebra, so many times you have to prove existence and uniqueness. So when we proved that, we proved it exists if and only if it's some if and only if it's this tensor product of evaluation modules, and these are all finite dimensional, and then you have this finite product, so the dimension. So this is the dimension of the module as a vector space, that's also finite dimensional, so short and sweet. Also, so I was trying to figure out what this is equal to, and I had this nasty expression, I'll pop it in. And actually, we realize it's very neat, where you just sum over partitions of n, and it looks like that, so that's nice. And this was like a main key to prove that last theorem, but look how long this proof is, so we need some lemmas, whatever these are, lemmas.
And then this is a proof of the proposition. My version of the proof. Super long, like, okay, one page. Oh my god, two pages. three pages, so that's where it ends, three pages. And my professor had an idea, and his was like a short proof. Just like one page.
So that's like how that all the work for that theorem went. And that was for a module over SL2 tensor polynomial ring in one variable over C. And now we're just trying to do the same thing, except this time for a GL11 tensor dot polynomial ring. So GL11's a least superalgebra, which gives us some new relations, different types of relations, and it's making things more interesting. So again, we have the cyclic module with some relations, and so we have some relations we imposed on it. And now we're seeing if that makes the module finite dimensional, which we want it to be. So if it's not, then we have to like impose some more relations on it. And right now it seems like it won't be. So that's basically what we're working on now. And it's pretty tricks, but it's also fun. It's cool. I like when combinatorics gets involved. So I'll check in with you guys probably after lunch. Hey, so I'm pretty sure I haven't checked in since lunchtime, but I just spent the afternoon reading for like 4 hours a textbook that had something to do with my project. And every second Tuesday, my city has like a local art making thing, and that was today, so that was really exciting. I had to miss last month, so I haven't seen these people in like 2 months, like virtually seen. But this is what I worked on today. I bought these markers because they're on sale at Michael's. And then this is what I drew with them. The hands were just some warm-up. But I was quite happy with it because it felt kind of like painting. They blend really well. So I like this fox. The girl's like meh, but I like these two babbies. These two cats. And this is what I accomplished, aka nothing, but it is what it is. It's 9 p.m. now, so it's much too late to do anything more. I'm just gonna shower because it's like 29 degrees here and super humid, and I've just been sweating all day even though I've only been sitting, so I need to get comfy before bed. And tomorrow's gonna be hopefully just as busy day, but maybe getting more stuff done. It's Thursday today, which means I just skipped over Wednesday, and that was because yesterday I was reading just to get some more background and try to find some techniques on proving something, because sometimes there are things out there which you may forget about or just not know, and it could be quite useful to your proof. So I was reading about Young Tableau yesterday, and today I'll try to apply what I read and see if I can do anything with it. I also have a tutorial today for my calculus class, and I have the exercise class again. And tomorrow I have my first violin lesson in like a year, so I really have to practice before that because I don't want to like embarrass myself, since I've been quite like demotivated to practice since I'm not having lessons regularly. So today I have my to-do list again, and already did one thing on it while I was drinking coffee this morning. I reviewed my Norwegian vocab, and then the next thing I will do is just quickly review all the questions they will have for the tutorial today. So I'm ready to answer them. So the summer tutorial is pretty easy to do as a TA for the summer calculus course. It's first year calculus, and the tutorial is basically the students get a list of questions to work on, and they have an hour and a half to work on them, and I'm just there to help them. So I don't need to prepare any lecture or anything like that. All I have to do is review like what they've been learning and make sure I'm ready to answer their questions. But at this point, it's first year calc, so like it's not that much to review for me. So I'm gonna get going on reviewing their problem set. Hopefully that won't take that long, and then I can get into my own work. I emailed the local art center about their summer pop-up series and if I would be able to participate in one, like selling my prints and stickers and stuff. And they emailed back to me and said yes, and they even have an opening this Saturday. And now I'm like very excited. I've never got a chance to do something like this before. And I get like quite emotional, and I'm like too excited to try and focus on my schoolwork, but I need to do that. I was looking through like what I could sell, and I found this, which is from my video about grad school online, which I'll link. But I actually like it. I forgot what I drew for that because I don't like to rewatch my videos. Like, I'm worried I'll hate it, but this is cute. Oh, pals. A print of her. It's my YouTube profile picture. But for some reason, I like how she turned out. And maybe also of this bad girl. She should have a background. So I just finished my exercise class and it was super hard, but I feel really good mentally. Like, it's like 1 hour where you have to work really hard on these things, so you don't have time to worry about your research and all that stuff. And it's just nice to be around other people. And honestly, if you have the opportunity to do some exercise, it doesn't have to be a whole hour. Even like 15 minutes, I really highly recommend it. It's a great form of self-care, both for your mental health and your physical health. So yeah, just some friendly advice from your big sis grad student.